نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار الحمد لله we praise Allah and we seek His assistance and we seek His forgiveness and we seek refuge in Allah from the evil within ourselves and from our bad deeds whoever Allah guides there is none that can lead him astray and whoever is led astray then there is no guide for him I bear witness that no God has the right to be worshipped other than Allah He is alone and has no partners and I bear witness that Muhammad is the slave and His messenger O you who believe, fear Allah as you ought to be feared, and don't die except as Muslims. O humanity, fear your Lord who has created you from a single soul and created from it its mate, and scattered from them to many men and women. And fear Allah from we demand your mutual rights, and don't cut off relations with the wombs that bore you. Indeed, Allah is a raqib over you. O you who believe, fear Allah and say that which is correct, in order that He may accept from you your deeds and forgive you of your sins. And whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger achieves the greatest achievement of Mabardu. Certainly the most truthful speech is the book of Allah, and the finest guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the most evil of affairs are newly invented matters in this deen, and every newly invented matter in this deen is a bid'ah, and every bid'ah is a strang, and every strang is in the fire. This evening we want to begin with Tuhafun min aqwal al-salaf, or gifts or presents from the statements of the salaf, collected by Abdullah al-Rubaykhi, or as his name is pronounced, Wallahu A'lam, of which we've titled this collection here, Virtuous Statements from Our Salaf al-Saleh, or how it's titled. The Shaykh, he says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد It was said to Hamadun ibn Ahmad Why is the speech of our predecessors, our Salaf, more beneficial than our speech? He said, That is because they spoke with the mightiness of Islam and the success of the souls and the pleasure of Ar-Rahman. And we speak for the mightiness of our souls and the desiring of this world and to please the creation. This is the end of his statement. May Allah show mercy on him. In light of that, the author, he says, in light of that, I love to gather a collection from the statements of our Salaf al-Saleh, our righteous predecessors, in different chapters of exhortation and wisdom and character that perhaps Allah would benefit us and the Muslims to work by and to take this advice or this preaching. And I have placed these chapters in order according to the alphabet, meaning Aleph, Ba, Ta. And I placed in every chapter what I saw to be appropriate from the narrated statements of our righteous predecessors. And I put in the footnotes where I collected these narrations from so that a person can refer back to them. And I also placed at the beginning of each chapter what was easy for me of an ayah or a hadith. And I ask Allah Al-Azim that He make our speech good and our actions righteous, and that He accepts from us and the Muslims. And we ask Him, the Exalted, not to hold us accountable if we forget or if we make mistakes, and to forgive us and our parents and all of the Muslims. Indeed, He is the one who hears and answers the dua. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. The Mu'allaf, written 1412 Hijra. The first chapter, the Shaykh Abdullah, he mentions, Hafizahullah, al-ikhlasu wa niyyatu, or sincerity and the intention. Allah Ta'ala, He says, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ حُنَفَاءَ وَيُقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَذَلِكَ دِينُ الْقَيِّمَةِ. In Surah Al-Bayyinah, verse number 5, where Allah Ta'ala, He says, and they were not commanded except to worship Allah sincerely in obedience to Him, hunafa, establishing the oneness of Allah and staying away from ascribing partners in worship with Him, and they establish the salah and they give the zakat, and that is the upright deen. وعن عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إنما الأعمال بالنيات وإنما لكل امرئ ما نوى. رواه البخاري ومسلم. On the authority of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu, he said, I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, actions are but by intentions, and a person only gets what he has intended. Collected by al-Bukhari and Muslim. وعن أبي العالية قال قال لي أصحاب محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تعمل لغير الله فيكلك الله عز وجل إلى من عاملت له. صفة صفوة, page number 126. I think I'm going to leave out the reciting of the footnotes and just limit myself to the quotations, inshallah ta'ala. On the authority of Abu al-Aliyah, he said, the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they said to me, don't work for other than Allah, so that Allah Azza wa Jal would make you rely upon the one who you are working for His sake. Abu al-Aliyah radiallahu anhu, he said, the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they said to me, don't work for other than Allah, because Allah Azza wa Jal, He would make you rely on the one who you were working for His cause. لما مات علي بن الحسين وجدوه يعول 100 أهل بيت في المدينة. He says, when Ali ibn al-Husayn died, we found that 100 families or 100 households in the city of Al-Madinah used to rely upon him to take care of them. When Ali ibn al-Husayn died, they found that 100 houses or families in the city of Al-Madinah used to depend on him to take care of them. قيل لي حمدون بن أحمد ما بال كلام السلف أنفع من كلامنا. قال لأنهم تكلموا لعز الإسلام ونجاة النفوس ورضا الرحمن ونحن نتكلم لعز النفوس وطلب الدنيا ورضا الخلق. It was said to حمدون بن أحمد, what is it that the speech of our righteous Salaf is more beneficial than our speech? He said, that is because they speak for the mightiness of Islam and the success of the souls and the pleasing of Ar-Rahman. And we speak for the mightiness of our souls or of the souls and desire of worldly gain and to please the creation. قال الربيع بن خيثم كل ما لا يراد به وجه الله يضمحل. الربيع بن خيثم, he said, everything that's done, everything that is not done for the face of Allah will disappear. الربيع بن خيثم, he says, everything that is done that is not done for the face of Allah, meaning the sake of Allah, then it will disappear. قال مجاهد إن العبد إذا أقبل إلى الله عز وجل بقلبه أقبل الله بقلوب المؤمنين إليه. مجاهد, he said, indeed the servant, if he turns to Allah عز وجل with his heart, then Allah will turn the hearts of the believers towards him. Mujahid, he said, indeed, the servant, if he turns towards Allah Azza wa Jal with his heart, then Allah will turn the hearts of the believers towards him. Qala rajul li Tamim al-Dari radiyallahu anhu, ma salatuka bil-layl? Faghadiba ghadaban shadida thumma qala, wallahi la rak'atan usalliha في جوف الليل في سر أحب إلي من أن أصلي الليل كله ثم أقصه على الناس. A man said to Tamim al-Dari رضي الله عنه, what is your night salat like? So he got extremely angry and he said, I swear by Allah, one raka'ah that I make in the middle of the night in privacy or in secret is more beloved to me than to make salat all night long and then tell the people about it. A man said to Tamim al-Dari, how is your night salat? So he got extremely angry and then he said, I swear by Allah that one raka'ah that I make salat of in the middle of the night in secret is more beloved to me than making salat all night long and then informing the people. قال سهل بن عبد الله ليس على النفس شيء أشق من الإخلاص لأنه ليس لها فيه نصيب. سهل بن عبد الله رحمه الله, he said, there is nothing more difficult to the soul for the soul than sincerity والإخلاص. Because there is no portion of it, of sincerity for the soul. Sahl ibn Abdullah said, there is nothing more difficult for the soul than al-ikhlas or sincerity, because there is nothing of it for the soul. Meaning, sincerity is all for Allah and not for yourself. Wallahu a'lam. قال أبو سليمان الداراني طوبى لمن صحت له خطوة واحدة لا يريد بها إلا الله تعالى. أبو سليمان الداراني, he said, give glad tidings to the one who has one step correct, not doing it except for Allah Ta'ala. Abu Sulaiman al-Darani said, give glad tidings to the one who has one step correctly done, not doing it except for Allah Ta'ala. وقال أيوب السختياني ما صدق عبد قط فأحب الشهرة. Ayyub al-Sakhtiyani, he said, no servant has ever been truthful before and he loves it to be known. Or he loves to be known. Ayyub al-Sakhtiyani, he said, no servant has ever been truthful and then he loves to be known. Or as the Shaykh says, قال مالك بن دينار قولوا لمن لم يكن صادقا لا يتعنى. Malik ibn Dinar, he said, say to the one who is not truthful, don't burden yourself. Malik ibn Dinar, he said, say to the one who is not truthful, Don't burden yourself. I want to add that similar to the statement of Allah Ta'ala, عَامِلَةٌ نَاصِبَةٌ تَصْلَى نَارًا حَامِيَةٌ. Hard work that leads to the hellfire. Meaning because it wasn't done sincerely and solely for the sake of Allah.
قَالَ يَحْيَى بْنُ مُعَاذٍ لَا يُفْلِحُ مَنْ شَمِمْتَ رَاحِعَةَ الرِّيَاسَةَ مِنْهُ.
قال يحيى بن معاذ لا يفلح من شممت رائحة الرياسة منه. يحيى بن معاذ, he said, the one who you smell the desire for leadership from him will not be successful. يحيى بن معاذ, he said, the one who you smell the desire for leadership from him, he will never be successful.
قال بعض السلف إني لأستحب أن يكون لي في كل شيء نية حتى في أكلي وشربي ونومي ودخولي الخلاء.
Some of our righteous predecessors used to say, indeed I love that I will have an intention in everything that I do, meaning a pure intention for Allah's sake in everything that I do. Even in my eating and my drinking and my sleeping and my entering into the bathroom or the lavatory. Some of our Salaf, they said, indeed, I love to have a pure intention for everything that I do. Even my eating and drinking and sleeping and entering the bathroom.
قال أبو عثمان سعيد بن الحداد ما صد عن الله مثل طلب المحامد وطلب الرفعة.
Abu Uthman Sa'id ibn al-Haddad, he said, nothing prevents a person from Allah, or nothing separates or prevents or hinders someone from Allah like desiring to be praised and desiring and wanting to shine, or wanting people to look up to him, or as the Shaykh means by his statement.
Abu Uthman Sa'id ibn al-Haddad, he said, nothing prevents or hinders one from Allah like desiring to be praised or wanting people to look up to him.
عن الربيع ابن صبيح قال كنا عند الحسن البصري فوعظ فانتحب رجل فقال الحسن أما والله ليسألنك الله عز وجل يوم القيامة ما أردت بهذا.
On the authority of Rabi' ibn Sabih, he said, we were with Al-Hasan al-Basri and he gave a speech, so a man began crying very loudly. So Al-Hasan, he said, I swear by Allah that Allah will definitely ask you, Allah Azza wa Jal will definitely ask you on the day of resurrection, what did you intend by that?
Al-Rabi' ibn Sabih, he said that we were with Al-Hasan al-Basri and he gave a speech and a man cried very loudly or raised his voice with his crying. So Al-Hassan, he said, I swear by Allah that Allah Azza wa Jal will definitely ask you about that on Yawm Al-Qiyamah. What did you intend by that?
وَقَالَ الْحَسَنْ كَانَ الرَّجُلُ يَكُونُ عِنْدَهُ زَوَّارُهُ فَيَقُومُ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ يُصَلِّي لَا يَعْلَمُ بِهِ زُوَّارُهُ وَكَانُوا يَجْتَهِدُونَ فِي الدُّعَاءِ وَلَا يَسْمَعُ لَهُمْ صَوْتًا وَكَانَ الرَّجُلُ يَنَامُ مَعَ امْرَأَتِهِ عَلَى وِسَادَةٍ فيبكي طول ليلته وهي لا تشعر.
Al-Hasan, he said that a man, he would have visitors with him and he would stand up and make salat at night and his visitors would know nothing of it. And they would be working hard making dua and you would not hear them at all. And a man, he would sleep with his wife on the same pillow and he would be crying all night long, meaning for Allah's sake, and she would not even know that.
Al-Hasan, he said, a man he would have visitors, and he would stand up and make salat all night long, and his visitors would know nothing of it. And they would work hard making dua, and you would not hear them at all. And a man would sleep on the same pillow with his wife, and he would cry all night long, and she would not realize it at all. قال محمد بن عدوية وعدوي سمعت الفضيل بن عياض يقول ترك العمل من أجل الناس رياء والعمل من أجل الناس شرك والإخلاص أن يعافيك الله منهما آمين. Muhammad ibn Adaway, he said, I heard Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad say, leaving off actions because of the people is hypocrisy, and working because of the people is shirk, and sincerity is that Allah saves you from both of them. May Allah save us from both of them. Muhammad ibn Adaway, he said that I heard Al-Fudayl say, that leaving off actions because of the people is hypocrisy or riya, and doing deeds because of the people is shirk, and sincerity is that Allah save you from the two. قال الفضيل رحمه الله من أحب أن يذكر لم يذكر ومن كره أن يذكر ذكر. الفضيل رحمه الله, he said, whoever loves to be mentioned won't be mentioned, and whoever hates to be mentioned will be mentioned. Al-Fudayl rahimahullah, he says, whoever loves to be mentioned, then he won't be mentioned, and whoever hates to be mentioned, then he will be mentioned. وقال ابن المبارك رحمه الله رب عمل صغير تكثره النية ورب عمل كثير تصغره النية. Ibn Mubarak rahimahullah, he said, perhaps a small action will be made plentiful because of its intention, and perhaps a lot of deeds will be made small or minimized because of the niyyah, because of the intention. Ibn Mubarak, he said, perhaps A small deed or a few deeds will be multiplied because of the niyyah, and perhaps many deeds will be minimized because of the intention. قال الشافعي رحمه الله تعالى وددت أن الناس تعلموا هذا العلم يعني كتبه على أن لا ينسب إلي منه شيء. الشافعي رحمه الله, he said, I loved that the people would learn this knowledge, meaning his books, except that they would not attribute any of it to me. Imam Shafi rahimahullah, he said, that I love that the people would learn this knowledge, meaning his books, except that they would not affiliate any of that with me. Or as he says, and that's the end of the chapter of Al-Ikhlas and sincerity. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with Al-Ikhlas, sincerity for His sake, and a good pure niyyah in every action that we do. Al-Istidraju, gradually setting one up for punishment, or as the Shaykh means by this statement. قال الله تعالى سنستدرجهم من حيث لا يعلمون, and we will gradually punish them from where they do not realize it. This is from Surah Al-Qalam, verse number 44. قال بكر بن عبد الله إذا رأيتم الرجل موكلا بعيوب الناس ناسيا لعيبه فاعلموا أن قد مكر به. Bakr ibn Abdullah, he said, if you see a man tied to the faults of the people, forgetting his own faults, then know that he has been duped or fooled. Bakr ibn Abdullah, he says, if you see a man tied or worried about the faults of the people, forgetting his own, then know that he has been fooled. قال بعض السلف رب مستدرج بنعم الله عليه وهو لا يعلم ورب مغرور بستر الله عليه وهو لا يعلم ورب مفتون بثناء الناس عليه وهو لا يعلم. Some of the Salaf, they used to say, perhaps someone is being set up by the favors of Allah upon him and he does not even realize it. And perhaps the conceited one is being covered by Allah's... Perhaps the conceited one, because of Allah's covering of him, and he doesn't realize it, or as the Shaykh means by a statement. And perhaps the one who is tested by the people's praise of him, and he does not even realize it. Some of the Salaf, they say, perhaps the one who's being set up gradually to be punished by the favors of Allah upon him, and he doesn't realize it. Meaning, wallahu a'lam, that Allah is blessing and favoring him, and he's not being tested at all, till he thinks that everything is really good for him, but Allah in fact is setting him up. And perhaps the one who is, perhaps the conceited one, or the one who is deceived by Allah's covering of him, and he does not know. And perhaps the one being tested by the praise of the people on him, and he doesn't know. قال بعض السلف إذا رأيت الله يتابع عليك نعمة وأنت مقيم على معصيه فاحذره فإنما هو استدراج منه يستدرجك به. Some of the Salaf, they used to say, if you see that Allah's favor upon you is coming one after another, and you are continuing to be disobedient to him, then be aware, because he is only using that to set you up with. Some of the Salaf, they used to say, if you see that Allah's favors are upon you, or following each other, Allah continues to favor you one time after the other, and you are continuing to be disobedient to him, and then be aware, because those favors are only a means to set you up, or to gradually set you up to be punished by. And this is the end of the chapter of al-istidraj, or gradually setting you up for punishment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from the punishment, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us to realize the real state of affairs, so that we don't get off track and gradually set ourselves up for his punishment. Al-istighfar wa tawbah, seeking forgiveness and repentance. Qal Allah ta'ala, ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, tubu ila Allahi tawbatan nasuha. Surah Al-Tahrim, verse number 8, where Allah ta'ala, he says, O you who believe, repent to Allah with a sincere repentance. وعن الأغر بن يسار المزني رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أيها الناس توبوا إلى الله واستغفروا فإني أتوب في اليوم 100 مرة رواه مسلم. On the authority of Al-Aghar ibn Yasar المزني رضي الله عنه, he said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, O humanity, repent to Allah and seek his forgiveness, because indeed I repent 100 times a day. Astaghfirullah alladhi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum. Qala Umar radiyallahu anhu, jalisut tawwabin فإنهم أرق شيء لأفئدة. Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, sit with those who repent, because indeed this is the thing that will soften the heart most. Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, sit with those who repent, because indeed this will soften the heart most. Or as he says, radiallahu anhu. قالت عائشة رضي الله عنها طوبى لمن وجد في صحيفته استغفارا كثيرا. Aisha radiallahu anha, she said, give glad tidings to the one who has much seeking of forgiveness on his scroll. Aisha radiallahu anha, she said, give glad tidings to the one who finds many much seeking of forgiveness on his scrolls, or his book of deeds. قال ابن شهاب عن سالم ما لعن ابن عمر خادما له إلا مرة فاعتقه. Ibn Shihab narrates on the authority of Salim that Ibn Umar رضي الله عنهما, he never cursed a servant of his except one time, and then he set him free. Ibn Shihab narrates on the authority of Salim, who is the son of Abdullah ibn Umar, who says that Ibn Umar, who is Abdullah ibn Umar, he never cursed a servant of his except one time, and he set him free. Meaning he set him free as a means of seeking forgiveness and repentance to Allah for cursing him. قال الحسن البصري رحمه الله أكثروا من الاستغفار في بيوتكم وعلى موائدكم وفي طرقكم